Kombuis word met trots geborg deur Van Loferen Wyne. Meer as 35 jaar al 'n trots Suid-Afrikaanse gunsteling.
So, hierdie man is gebore in Wallis en hy kook nou al vir Suid-Afrikaners en in Suid-Afrika vir meer as 6 jaar. Chef Adrian Vaughan van Sun Times Square, welkom by die groot ontbyt.
Thank you very much.
Welcome, baie dankie. Honey.
Thank you, honey.
We really hope you feel
very welcome. Yes, a bit of British here this morning.
Yes, sorry,
something we don't normally see.
That's the closest accent I can do.
That's fine. That's no problem. I'm used to people taking the mic out of the accent, so don't worry about that.
Listen, so I'm very intimidated by what I see in front of me. What is this going to be part of?
So we're going to do a fillet of sea bass this morning, some wilted greens with a pom puree and a prawn bisque. So nothing too dramatic. Something nice and simple, classic Mediterranean style food. Obviously, being from the UK, that's what I've grown up with, that's what I've cooked. So you go back to what you know.
Mm.
So obviously, that's what we're going to do this morning. So at the moment, we've got a potato puree on cooking. So the potatoes are just boiling away. Once that's done, what we're going to do is we're going to put it into the blender. And we're just going to add some cream, a touch of milk, and some butter. And we're just going to whip it up so it's almost like a mousseline. So instead of a mash, it's just very light and very airy.
Oh,
we're pairing that with a very simple wilted green. So you've just got some baby spinach, some little broccoli tender stems where we've just kind of trimmed them off, off of the main tender stem broccoli.
Yeah.
Some fennel, just to give you that aniseed, which works really nicely with fish. Some kind of baby onions or little shallots. And then we'll cook all of those together very gently down, and then that's going to form the base of what we're going to pop the fish on.
So, and I think in Afrikaans you call that gesouteerde groente.
I'll take your word for it. Okay. I don't honestly know.
I could say anything now, no?
Yes, exactly. You could pretty much say anything, and I wouldn't know too much. I know some Afrikaans words, because a lot of my chefs, obviously, from the country like to take the mickey out of me. So I've picked up some of them, but they're the type you can't put on air.
Yes.
So obviously I'm not going to mention those
Well,
ones.
At least you can say thank you in Afrikaans.
Yes, exactly. Almost.
Yeah.
It kind of more sounds like, you know, by donkey rather than by donkey. So, you know, I try my hardest. You know, you've got to emulsify yourself.
Don't buy a donkey in this case,
yes,
buy a fish.
Don't. Yes, a nice piece of sea bass.
And that's what we have. I actually read up about a sea bass, and you can correct me, but I heard that it's from the Pacific Ocean. It's an Asiatic kind of fish, and they also call it a Suzuki. So I don't know if bikers got some motivation
think so.
From a fish.
But it's a hunting fish, so you can see by obviously the shape and by kind of the mouth and the way that it's set up that it's a hunting fish. So it's got a beautiful finish and a beautiful taste to it, which obviously linked with everything that we're doing is going to give you a fabulous dish at the
end. I can see in its eyes, it's very fiery, it's
yes,
aggressive
it's,
kind
it's
of
a bit like a chef,
hunting.
That's why we like to use it. But let me give you, I've got a jacket with me for you from Sun Times Square.
Wow.
So whilst I'm busy with the potatoes and the wilted greens, if you can just fillet the fish for me, a nice center cut piece, nicely trimmed up, pin boned.
Okay, yes,
cool.
Of course,
perfect.
Chef, I will just fillet this fiery, aggressive hunting fish all by myself. I've got a knife, I've got a jacket now. And if I understand correctly, I'm actually supposed to do this.
Yes, so from the top all the way down through past the two fins there.
Okay, so whilst I'm doing this and filleting the whole fish by myself, you're gonna watch some other stuff and wish me good luck. Hopefully I have a hand left when we return. So stay tuned. Welkom terug. Soos julle kan sien, het ek daai reuse sea bass op my eie gefileteer. Hierdie is nou wat oor is van hom. Eintlik het chef Ramon Gous gou-gou ingekom en ons gehelp om die vis te fileteer, terwyl chef Adrian Vaughan van Times Square gou-gou vir ons groente gesorteer het. If you can just remind us quickly, chef, what happened in here?
So all we did is we just took the little baby shallots, cooked them down with a little bit of oil, touch of butter. We threw in the kind of little baby fennel, which we just finely cut on the bias, just to give it like a nice kind of shape. And then we just let that sit. We put the little florets of broccoli inside, and then we threw the spinach on top. So the spinach naturally would just wilt down. So we're not trying to cook the spinach so it's got that horrible watery flavor. It's just gonna kind of release the juices, and the heat from the pan will just kind of very gently wilt the spinach down.
Mm.
So it kind of gives you a totally different texture on the spinach instead of like cream spinach or so on. It's just very gently wilted. So it's got that lovely finish to it. So it gives you that real spinachy flavor through.
Spinachy flavor.
Spinachy flavor.
I love it. And what is going to complement the spinachy and fishy flavor today?
So you've got, we obviously were talking about the bisque. So what we've done is we've taken prawn shells, and we've cooked it with a mirepoix, which is a culinary term that the chefs love to throw around, which basically means vegetables.
Okay.
But specific types of vegetables to kind of emancipate the flavor of the shells that you're using. So if you're using prawn shells, you'd put a bit of fennel in there, a little bit of carrot, a little bit of onion, and then you'd put aromatics in, things like peppercorns or bay leaves. So it just kind of gives you a beautiful finished flavor. And then all we've done is we've just blended them up, and we've just hit them with a little hand blender just to kind of foam it up so it's got a lovely finish on the plate.
And then which wine do you think will complement this dish?
It's a difficult one because it's actually got so many different flavors to it, but I think a nice Sauvignon Blanc would be perfect because it's got that lovely crisp finish. So it would lovely cut through the fish and also through the bisque. So we're just gonna turn the fish over now.
And it's quite a thick piece of
fish,
Nick.
Sorry to interrupt you. So when you're cooking it, you've obviously got to have a look at kind of the depth of the piece of fish. So when you turn it over, what we're looking for is, you can see here where it's kind of opaque. We're kind of looking for that to just go away very gently. So you've got a beautifully cooked and finished fish. So
wow.
Where it's kind of gone white, that's where it's cooked currently. And then we've turned it over just to kind of finish off the fish so that it cooks from both sides. So that you actually don't have direct heat coming all the way through the fish.
Wow.
And then we're just gonna finish that off with a little bit of butter in there. The butter's there for flavor, but it also kind of gives a nice finish to the fish in terms of, you know, it's gonna go kind of quite nutty, the butter in the pan, so we'll just monte that over the fish to kind of give it that really nice flavor.
Yo, and now you're gonna teach me how to plate this fish in a very simple way.
Yes.
To look good for the guests. I guess we start with the sauteed vegetables.
We're gonna start with the sauteed vegetables, but we wanna put our pomme puree on. So it's a very quick one. The pomme puree goes in the center of the plate. So you got this lovely kind of mash, like a really
creamy
and kind of finished mashed potato. So we're just gonna put that in the middle. Just gonna kind of spread it out a little bit, get a nice kind of base for everything. And then all we're gonna do is put the wilted greens just to the side of that.
To the side of that?
Yes, sorry, just across here so that you still get to see some of the puree. But you obviously get to see that lovely, the lovely greens going through.
And if I do it with a nuance of je ne sais quoi, does it
Yes,
make better?
The je ne sais quoi makes the dish. So if you
of
don't
course.
Have je ne sais quoi, then the dish just doesn't finish right.
Okay, and now we're just gonna finish off with the fish on top.
Yep.
And while you're doing that, I'm thanking you for visiting us. And Ramon also last week, thank you so much, it was wonderful. And you can see more on social media and Sun Times Square. Cheers.